What to Play presents 25 of the most anticipated PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5 titles coming up this year and beyond. With E3 coming to a close, we gave more priority to the game showcase during the event. To see the complete list, check out our website at whattoplay.com. Link in the description box below.
They will fight. And they will die. In an unending curse.
Elden Ring. FromSoft's next project goes above and beyond to bring the ultimate Souls-like adventure in a new format. Miyazaki and George R.R. Martin's Love Child is now an open-world action RPG set in a gorgeous new universe. The recent trailer gave us enough to speculate about what's to come, especially with its insane roster of bosses and character design. It's coming to the PS4 and the PS5 this January 21st, 2022.
For all of us.
Avatar: Frontiers of Pandora. We gotta admit, Ubisoft's panel gave us a lot of titles, but none surprised us better than this one. Frontiers of Pandora is the Avatar game we never knew we needed. With Ubisoft taking the helm as its publisher, one could assume it's a massive open-world game where we can ride alien dinosaurs and shoot mechanical giants with arrows. It's scheduled for release on the PS5 next year.
I watched Castillo order a whole boat of our people shot to death. And I want to know who's going to help me take him down.
Okay.
Far Cry 6. Here we have another game from Ubisoft. The follow-up to their chaotic first-person shooter series gets a new protagonist and a chilling antagonist. Destabilize an oppressive government and end Anton Castillo's rule. As a freedom fighter, use a variety of weapons at your disposal to give your people a fighting chance, animals included. It's set to release the 7th of October on both PS4 and PS5 consoles.
I used to feel so much peace, staring into the heavens, until a piece of it fell.
Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Extraction. If you enjoy Rainbow Six Siege, ironically, you might not enjoy this one. This is far removed from its core tactical shooting experience, but you still get to see your favorite operators dishing out their gadgets. Extraction is a glorified PvE shooter similar to Valve's Left 4 Dead. Instead of shooting each other, we shoot evolving organisms using our specialized tools. It's coming to the PS4 and the PS5 on September 16. God of War Ragnarok. After it was revealed that it was going to get pushed back to next year, nobody was surprised given how little information we've had since the game was announced. Ragnarok is turning out to be a huge turning point for Kratos and for the God of War fans. Who knows what'll happen in this epic showdown of the gods? One thing's for certain though, it's coming to both PS4 and PS5 consoles. Atomic Heart. It's been a while since we've played the BioShock series, and Atomic Heart's similarities with Irrational's award-winning shooter can really scratch that itch. Make your way around its surreal fever dream of a Soviet setting. Mix and match gunplay with magic abilities to take down a variety of threats coming your way. Sure, it comes out on the PS4 too, but its improved visuals and RTX tech works wonders on the PS5. A Plague Tale: Requiem. We've seen the horrors Amicia and Hugo went through in A Plague Tale: Innocence, and we wish to never see them in those situations again. Unfortunately, the world is still a brutal place, and these royal siblings are still in for a wild ride in its rat-infested streets. It comes out sometime next year for the PlayStation 5. Back for Blood. The answer to anyone looking for a new Left 4 Dead game. Although Valve is no longer funding these guys, they're pretty much the same people that worked on our once favorite zombie PvE first-person shooter. Back for Blood is built for pure multiplayer goodness. Team up with friends in the four-player co-op, or tear them apart in its PvP mode. An open beta is in the works, so check it out if you want to try it before it releases on the PS4 and the PS5 this October 12th. Evil Dead the Game. Speaking of zombies, let's not forget about this popular franchise. If you're familiar with Dead by Daylight or Friday the 13th, you'll find a ton of similarities in Evil Dead the game. Its PvPvE mode surprisingly blends well in a game set in Ash's crazy horror-filled universe. It's releasing sometime this year, and it's available on the PS4 and the PS5.
Come on, let's dance! Or take my picture with your new camera.
Life is Strange Remastered Collection. Whether you like it or not, the Life is Strange series has touched the hearts of many with its interesting characters and memorable soundtrack. Deck 9 brings new life to Max and Chloe's adventures. In this remastered collection, you'll play an enhanced version of Before the Storm and the first Life is Strange. It's built for those 4K displays and anyone itching to play the story again. Coming this September 10th alongside True Colors.
Whatever happens, I'll always have your back. Always.
You cannot hide from fate. But you can make your own.
Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. Forget Borderlands, they're going ham with his newfound magical powers now. This spin-off to the bizarre looter shooter from Gearbox takes players into a world caught in an identity crisis. There's magic, unicorns, and dragons here, but there's also a massive selection of firepower that reminds us that yes, it's still Borderlands. It's coming early next year for the PS4 and PS5. Jurassic World Evolution 2. Build a massive empire full of bioengineered creatures and try not to replicate the death toll of its movie counterparts. Dinosaur enthusiasts will find more building options in this sequel to the theme park simulator of their dreams. Not only that, Evolution 2 features a story mode for anyone looking for original content in the Jurassic franchise. It's set to release sometime this year for the PS4 and PS5.
Psychonauts headquarters! Look at all these gadgets!
The mind is the final frontier of humanity.
I'm ready for anything!
Psychonauts 2. It's time we use our heads again in this much-anticipated sequel to Double Fine Games' cult classic. With the power of psychokinesis, manipulate the environment around you and solve myriad puzzles in its platforming wonder. The game is slated for an August 25th release, and it'll come out for the PS4 and the PS5.
There's no never here. Just you, me, and the rest of these maniacs.
Bring it, baby.
Deathloop. Arkane Studios' latest project after their gritty Dishonored series. The studio didn't get a chance to showcase their fine work at this year's E3, but they did give us a tease of their new IP, Redfall. Nonetheless, this time-bending shooter mixes Dishonored's first-person shooting action and BioShock's multiple environment manipulating abilities. It's coming this September 14th for the PlayStation 5. Tales of Arise. Bamco's latest Tales game might be familiar for series veterans, but for newcomers, it's the first of the series to embrace the next-gen feel with quite possibly the best-looking visuals in the series yet. The recent trailer gave us a glimpse on the playable characters and some snippets of its real-time combat. It comes out on the PS4 and PS5 on September 10th. The Dark Pictures House of Ashes. The latest chapter of the anthology horror series from Supermassive Games. House of Ashes will retain the same quality of its interactive experience with decisions that affect the game's story and ending. It stars High School Musical's Ashley Tisdale as she and a group of CIA operatives find themselves trapped in a mysterious abyss. It comes out this October 22nd for the PS4 and the PS5. Two Point Campus. You've seen the lengths we'd go to in a hospital setting. It's about time we try to mess around campus life in the craziest way possible. The Two Point games have never taken themselves too seriously. Two Point Campus brings all that humor and creativity while also introducing new concepts to the mix. It comes out next year for both consoles.
Alex!
so good to see you again. Welcome to Haven.
This place is pretty sweet. Life is Strange, True Colors. Deck 9 takes the helm to introduce another chapter to the Life is Strange series. Follow Alex Chen in her journey to find the mystery behind her brother's death. Like all Life is Strange games, a supernatural twist is always around. Alex's newfound powers of empathy can let her read and change people's emotions. All episodes will be available on one day once it comes out this September 10th for the PS4 and the PS5. Sifu. It seems like everybody is kung fu fighting in this upcoming brawler from the makers behind Absolver. The gameplay features detailed hand-to-hand combat akin to Jackie Chan and Bruce Lee movies. It's expected to release this year on both the PS4 and the PS5. Farming Simulator 22. Let's not forget about the award-winning farming game from Giant Software. Live the life of a modern farmer and grow your empire of crops and livestock throughout the European and American environments. It comes out this fourth quarter for the PS4 and PS5. Horizon Forbidden West. Aloy returns. And this time, she takes her journey to the lush yet desolate jungles of San Francisco. A new threat emerges and she's well equipped with the right weapons. Forbidden West raises the stakes of the metallic enemies from the previous game, adding massive mechanical mammoths to the fray. It's a cross-gen release, so expect them to be playable on both PlayStation consoles. Kena: Bridge of Spirits. Ember Lab's ambitious title is nearing its release, and the previews are looking promising so far. If Horizon involves a woman battling mechanized monsters, Kenna's journey takes her to a mystical land corrupted by darkness. Its third-person gameplay might be familiar for some players, but its selling point is its gorgeous animations and art style. It feels like a Pixar film. It's coming out to PlayStation consoles on August 24th. Dying Light 2. Zombies plus parkour has always been Dying Light's strongest aspect. In 2, they take it up a notch with more choices for your journey. Now with a stronger emphasis on RPG, making tough decisions now affects the story. Like the original, the game gets crazier at nighttime, so prep those weapons, otherwise you'd be zombie food. Coming to the PS4 and PS5 on December 7th.
Guardians of the Galaxy?
What? No, Rocket!
So, I let Groot fill out the paperwork.
Guardians of the Galaxy. Looks like the guys at Eidos Montreal are back for another dose of Marvel goodness. Unlike Avengers, this is a pure single-player story where you play as Quill and control your Guardians.
Drop him, Gamora! This won't hurt! Much!
Smash him off, Drax! Meet your maker!
Boys enjoying this way too much.
This is the local fauna.
This is Square Enix's take on the ragtag group of bounty hunters, and while it does feel weird seeing them with different models, it's a breath of fresh air somehow. It comes out sometime this October for both consoles. Hogwarts Legacy. We end this list with a recently delayed entry. It failed to show its face during this year's E3, but for good reasons. For Harry Potter fans, this is the RPG they've always wanted. They can finally make their own character, practice spells, and enter the halls of Hogwarts doing some crazy magic. Let's hope its open world lives up to the hype. It comes out sometime next year for both consoles.